We live in a fast-paced world, and our lives are pressure-filled. Our days are jam-packed with deadlines and meetings. We are constantly bombarded with news, entertainment, and advertising, with computerized data, emails, and social networking. It sometimes feels that we've forgotten how to slow down, to pause for a moment, and to reflect on the things that are genuinely important in our lives, and to fully appreciate how fortunate we are to be Americans. Ours is a great nation, and it's not because we are a nation filled with gleaming skyscrapers, safe and vibrant hometowns, bountiful farms and beautiful parks, powerful industries and centers of science and technology. These are all wonderful things, but they aren't what makes our nation great. No, what makes the United States of America truly great is our freedom. The freedom that was won by generations of courageous Americans who have served in uniform. And throughout our nation's history, many of these heroes have been New Yorkers. When our ragtag colonial army overcame a mighty British Empire, New Yorkers were there. When Union soldiers battled to preserve our young nation at Gettysburg, Bull Run, and Antietam, New Yorkers were there. From the bloody beaches of Normandy to the rocky cliffs of Iwo Jima, to the epic Battle of Midway, New Yorkers were there. When the trailblazing Tuskegee Airmen flew with pride and valor, New Yorkers were there. At the liberation of the Dachau concentration camp, New Yorkers were there. From Heartbreak Ridge in Korea, to the brutal siege at Khe San, to the desert battlefields of the First Gulf War, New Yorkers have always served, just as they are serving to this day in Operation Enduring Freedom. Driving tyrants from power, overcoming fascism and communism, and defending freedom at home and abroad, New Yorkers have always been there. By the thousands they have come, young kids from Long Island, the Big Apple, and across upstate, from Belmore, Brooklyn, Binghamton, and Buffalo, from the suburbs, family farms, and small towns throughout this great state. When our nation is called, New Yorkers have always responded, and they have always sacrificed. And countless New York families have sacrificed as well. The thousands of loving mothers and fathers, husbands and wives, sons and daughters, who have known the sacrifice, the loneliness, and the heartbreak caused by war. So the next time that you sit down at the dinner table, join your family in worship, or tuck your children in at night, maybe it's time to slow down, to take stock, and to remember that it is our freedoms that make our nation great. And to also remember that it is precisely these freedoms that have been secured for us by the courageous men and women of America's armed services, from the dawn of our nation right up to this very moment. Thank you for your service, and God bless America.